Cheers and go take seat. The great classic. Slip quick way. Go take. My companion, Mr. Bell, an accustomed as he is to the ways of Africa, is new to this mission. The QRC commander, the master cook, should not be shipped with breakfast by now, you know
what I mean?
I'm just gonna walk through this on video for a little while anyway, because I really am on doing tech and I'm like, that's not fair. It's not fair at all.
And coming back for 100,000 rides before you break even.
So can you tell me what's it like growing up as an Italian?
Excuse me, I'm dozing off. Sitting just that quick. I'm trying to see me telling me. I'm telling me. I feel like I'm being tortured. And I'm like, okay, I don't know what to do. I'm saying black people doing something. Watching my personal life. And I thought I would do a open study or documentary where I tell several groups of people, including preteen girls, preteen boys, black women, and even white women, to follow my routine every day for the next 30 days or for the next 2 weeks, and then tell us what happened to you. Tell us what happened to you. You know, why are you riding that so hard? To see what happened. People don't care. No, they don't care. But I want to be videotaped saying that God is telling me something. I keep falling asleep. That's how tired I am. The Bible says that I lay me down and slept, but I woke for the Lord sustained me. Lord is saying something about, I'm not the one that the whites are looking at me trying to like, trying to see what's fine on my body. It's being said.
Now we're going. Use the card that gets you miles closer to your promise. Like your first trip to Vancouver. And start something priceless.
I'm just gonna see her because like I said, my body is on attack. I can put this phone down.
And starting at $6.99, you can only do one thing. How fast can I get to Denny's? Get a burger and fries from Denny's starting at $6.99.
I'm Captain Obvious, and Hotels.com will be basic everywhere. So why am I hosting a dimension after party in my Vegas suite? Or wearing a full-body wetsuit at this spa retreat? Or sliding into this ski lodge with my mini horse cabin? Because Hotels.com lets me do me, right? Sorry, the cold makes him a little horse. Hotels.com. You do you, and get rewarded. You're wearing a hat. That's funny.
On the next Anthony Bourdain Parts Unknown.
Okay, you say that. God's telling some minister. He's telling the black woman she don't need to know what I'm doing to be happy. She know what I'm trying to, God trying to tell me.
My grandmother was the family historian and was very proud of our ancestry. I began researching different companies to do DNA testing.
So I still feel attacked. I still feel attacked. So I can't tell where the attack is coming from right now. It's coming from people who think they're supposed to do what I'm saying without including me in it. That should come from people who think they're supposed to do what I'm saying and include me in it. Get off my YouTube page. YouTube is copyright protected. I know you're very confident. That if you have a lawsuit, then you probably won't win. I know you're confident in that.
Live in the Dish Network app or the Fox Sports app. Every Fox football game Thursday through Sunday. Now let's go, baby. Touchdown! Oh, come on, somebody else try.
Uncle Terry, they're going for two.
Uncle Terry, they're going for two.
You'll never miss a moment of Fox Sports football with Dish.
The Van Jones Show, Saturday night at 7 Eastern on CNN.
Closed captioning brought to you by Page Publishing. We help publish, distribute, and sell your book.
Have you written a book and want it published? Thousands of authors have with Page
Publishing. Okay, so I just felt an attack on my body. And God says the white woman telling the black woman that I can't do what she did. Now, what the fuck they got to do with anything? Let me be quiet and just listen. Now I was on my YouTube page and making several videos. I made several videos just like, I said, why people must have heard or seen it and think I'm asking them something. And so they're coming after me, preemptively, viciously. Yeah. And it's something, it's gotta be some crazy bitches.
Conservancy seeks to address the problem of keeping all this alive and safe without excluding or marginalizing the people who've lived here for centuries. That is a delicate balance, man and nature. How to responsibly care for one without negatively impacting the other in a world of ever-decreasing resources.
Residential job. Hi, Dave.
Our guide is Karmu Shukiyama. He grew up in a village near here and has a deep knowledge of the wildlife of Loa.
Termite mounds, yeah?
That's filled with termites.
That's filled with termites.
That's horrible. Useless career in a firefight. You hide behind one of those, you can provide useful cover.
It's my first safari, and it's a very specific safari with an expert and with you with useless information.
Yes.
I paid extra for this.
Not a bitch went on my page, used my shit, talking about she supposed to know how to do that without including me. And now she won't know the bitch she fucking some white woman. do she want me? Because she was using stuff all my day. Now, you know people is a mess. You know people is a mess, huh? Well, first of all, let me clarify something. I don't want to go behind something like that. So you never have to worry about that. And in fact, go fuck every white woman in America. This is your number. I want every white woman to fuck one of these stupid bitches. Because I don't want to go behind no shit like that. That'll alleviate all your fear. Go to the Census Bureau. Find every white woman in America. Go fuck that hoe. And then you never have to worry about if I move to Walmart. Because I don't want to go behind shit like you. Bitches crazy, and white people love that shit. White people love that shit so much they eating this motherfucker ass. Like, this like if she say what I'm saying is the people that I'm with don't want her. Well, let me tell you something. Now sit down and think about if a bitch say what your wife say, would you leave? Half of these motherfuckers would look for something better anyway. They just with the white they with. So something better come along in fucking mess. So yeah, they'll leave. Girl, if a motherfucker get up and go with you on some bullshit, they can fucking have it. No. Let me read my Bible and try to be quiet and hear what God is trying to say, because I'm tired of being under attack. I'm tired of being under attack by some stupid bitch. Some stupid monkey.
Set up specifically to protect these guys. Initially, a cattle ranch owned and operated by the Clegg family, the Kenyan government, after finally acknowledging that the rhinoceros was on the verge of extinction, asked the family to set aside some of their property to bring all surviving rhinos here to recover and hopefully restore their numbers. From only 15 animals a few years back, there are over 150 of them today. Ever-present danger to both the animals that they love and the people who look after them. Particularly the rhinoceros, whose horn is believed by wealthy Chinese buyers to be a strong medicine with virility enhancing powers. The reality that the substance that makes up a rhino horn is the same as the human fingernail does not deter a market that will pay tens of thousands of dollars for a single horn. With 62,000 acres to cover, Lewa's anti-poaching program is necessarily aggressive, inclusive, and cutting-edge, relying on local trackers, advanced tracking technologies, and perhaps most importantly, good community outreach and intelligence gathering. If the local people are not on your side, you are at a serious disadvantage.
So that's a white one.
It's a white one?
It is a white color. It has nothing to do with the television. White was an uncommon light, which means white one. And here that came to white one, because I knew that, and it became white.
You said white line.
That's not white.
Speaking bad, might be black.
What a shithole, right?
I mean, the other thing I'm aware of too is that it's, you know, on the trip, but still that thing about like not wanting to feel like I am home, you know? Mm-hmm. And you have to take this guy's work connection, even though I do not come from home, you know? It's nice to have that connection. Even if the plane, like, that connection is working, it's flowing. You know, that's not, you know, it's the good part of it. It brings people together. It's kind of a compulsory view. Like, if you ever run for president, you should be compulsory.
At the very least, I do think that a lot of perspectives will be opened up, a lot of minds will be changed. You know, this is on a very personal note. Like, the idea that I'm sitting here with you doing this now, knowing where my life and career is from, pretty cool.
Yeah, no, it's like every now and again I have this, like, whose life is this?
I will tell you, I got 7 people, and I as soon as the pain started, and the crew was supposed to sit down, we have a half time. I cannot believe that I didn't do this.
I mean, like,
I'll see this ever. That was what I ever would have been. 43 years old, Duncan flies. I knew the absolute safety that I would never, ever seen home much like that.
Thank you. some sort of conservation culture, sort of looking at it. It's been with us, been with our forefathers. We just lost it somehow, recently, and we're trying to get it back.
When you have traditional pastoral communities under intense and immediate pressure, trying to convince them that wildlife, which can, as in the case of an elephant, bring in life-changing amounts of money, it's a hard thing to convince them that it is in their long-term interest to let them live. Particularly those often wealthy white outsiders doing the asking.
If you're very successful in managing this extra amount of public concerns, you've got wildlife across the country as a whole, how many people are going to be able to establish the zoo? More lives. And so what may we possibly do is show anyone that actually are having a lot of value.
Mike Watson is the CEO of the Land Conservancy. Tom Romampa leads the Northern Range Land Trust. Faith Nyonga is the head of education at LARA. And Wanji Kukunatia is the head of communication.
You're responsible for a larger picture. It involved a huge challenge for the immediate needs of a lot of people, but also potential conflict with the traditional way of life. How have you been able to do what you've been able to do?
I was when I'm working, you know, very strong, hospital, and who I really am thinking about the conversation. Really, and because one, we have a perception that this is a good thing, this is about working our land.
Tell us it's not the land that is owned by white people, right? Like, somebody else is owning out there.
Initially, that's it. But those are perceptions that conservative team is given by the white people. And so, it's not about the communities, it's not about us, it's about them. But you know, gradually, we came to realize that the approach that was being introduced was a community approach.
Going back 13 years back, there was one girl who made it to high school, and she's speaking English, she's dressing up, and the other girls are like, you know what, I'd like to be her. And the more and more and more they've seen, go through high school, graduate, slowly but slowly, they get to see the value of themselves. Education works very well.
Are there efforts for the people in the community who couldn't afford to come in here to see what's going on in here so they can have
afforded by it? We have a conservation education program here where over 3,500 school children can come on to LARA free of charge, go around, to see wildlife. Because you know, unless you can afford to go to national parks or to places like LARA, then you definitely will have the opportunity to interact with wildlife.
So now you can see at the foot, you can just see something sticking to lines in the ocean.
Wow.
If you're lucky, you're not coming in the